Yes, today I'm going to explain the three types of CSMA/CA method. Okay, that is nothing but first one is interframe space, second one is contention window, third one is acknowledgement. Okay, so this is what so this is what the three strategies or three methods are we supposed to explain today. So first I'm going to explain the interface like interframe space time. Okay, the interframe space time, okay, it is the main intention to avoid the collision avoid collision okay with the different transmission time, okay, or during the different transmission time, okay, we have to avoid the collision. This is the one of the main role of the interframe space. Okay, then after that it is going to check the condition, okay, the given line, whether it is whether the line is ideal or busy. Okay, the when line is ideal, it is going to found, okay, during that time the station does not send immediately any data immediately. Okay, then it could be wait for some amount of time or some period of time. Okay, that is nothing but time interface space. Okay, means that is nothing but interframe space time. Okay, why? Because this time it is going to allows the front of the transmitted signal by the distant station to reach the station, means like it is going to allow the transmitted signal with the different different stations to reach the particular frames, means it gives the permission to other devices or other stations also, it can take place the transaction, so that initially if line will be ideal, the primary station is supposed to wait for some amount of our interframe space time. Okay, so if it is still ideal, okay, after interframe space time also the channel still ideal, okay, that channel or that line again we need to reset that particular time, after then only we can allow to send the data to particular destination, okay, along with the contention time. Okay, the contention time is nothing but, okay, it is going to divide the time slot, so that is what the contention time. Okay, we will explain the contention, what is the contention windows time. Okay, the contention window time, okay, it is going to tell us about the some amount of time it is going to divide into their own time slots. Okay, is nothing but, okay, suppose I am having 10 hours. Okay, during that time 10 hour, this the 10 hour is the amount of time. Okay, the 10 hour I am going to divide the each and every slots, means the 1 hour, or it may be 1 hour, it may be half an hour. Okay, as per the based on the usage, okay, we supposed to divide the time slots. So that is nothing but the contention time. Okay, the station it is going to ready to send, okay, send the frames to destination. Okay, send the frames to destination. Okay, during that time the sender, it is going to choose the some random amount of time slots. Okay, but during that time only the transaction will be taken place. Okay, the number of slots in the contention window, it is going to change, okay, according to the binary exponential back of strategy. Okay, like the binary exponential format, it is going to change. Okay, the number of time slot it is going to change, okay, according to the exponential format. Okay, then this case the stations needs to each and every station it is going to checking, or it is going to sensing the each and every time the channel, okay, whether the given each time slot it is the free or free or busy. Okay, if it is channel is busy, okay, it does not process any like any data, means it does not send any data, okay, means it is going to stop the stop the transaction. Okay, if it is ideal, okay, it is going to restart that particular time slot. After that, again it is going to take care the transaction. Okay, means what I am going to tell this continuation window, okay, it is going to check the condition whether busy or ideal. Okay, if it is busy, okay, the given time slot or the given time, okay, if it is busy, it is going to stop the for sending the data to destination. Okay, if it is ideal, okay, the given amount of time or the given time slot, it is going to restart. Okay, restart that time slot, again it is going to send the particular data to destination. So this is what the our continuation time. Then the third method is acknowledgement. The acknowledgement, okay, we have two types here. One is positive acknowledgement and negative acknowledgement. See, well, like when become positive acknowledgement, okay, the positive acknowledgement, okay, without any collision, okay, it is going to send the frames to destination, and then it is going to receive the acknowledgement from the receiver side. This method we call it as a positive acknowledgement. Okay, so this positive acknowledgement, may we call it as a timeout. Okay, timeout acknowledgement means within that time it is going to receive the acknowledgement. Okay, within that time it is going to, the transaction will be taken care or taken place. So this method we call it as a positive acknowledgement. For negative acknowledgement, okay, during or during the transaction time, okay, in between that rather packet or the frame will be lost, means the receiver is not able to receive their particular frames, okay, during that time we call it as a negative acknowledgement. So why? Because our sender, he never received the acknowledgement back from the receiver, so that we call it as a negative acknowledgement. The next one is control access. So what is the control access here? The control access, it is going to access all the stations, okay, all the stations constantly from like one by one. Okay, it is going to access all the stations one by one. Okay, and the all the station it is going to control by our control access. Okay, means it is going to find which station has a right station to send the frame to receiver. Okay, so this is what the control access method. Okay, here it have three methods. The one is reservation method, second one is pooling method, and token passing method or token management method. The first one is reservation method. Okay, the reservation method is nothing but the reservation method, the station it is going to make the reservation before sending the data, means each station, okay, it is going to pre-booking the data, okay, before sending. Okay, so this method we call it as a reservation method. Okay, means, well, like suppose I am going to send the data, okay, after some amount of time, or like after 2 hours I am supposed to send the data to particular destination. Okay, before that only I am going to pre-reserving that particular time. Okay, so that method we call it as a reservation method. Okay, the time is divided into interval time. Yes, obviously the given amount of time, it is going to divide into interval time or divided into slots. Okay, particular slots. The each interval time, okay, the reservation frame, it is going to precede the day frames sent to interval time, means the given amount of time, okay, that is going to divide into interval time, or the it is going to divide into different slot time slot. Okay, during that time only the reservation frame, it is going to taken care the transaction means it is going to the transaction or communication will be takes place between the sender and receiver. Okay, if there are n station, I means number of station in the system, okay, there are exactly number of reservation in mini slot in the reservation frame, okay, means number of not only for each station, okay, the number of station also it can be